Hey fellow NeRF and Gaussian splatting enthusiasts. In this video we'll go over how to use spectacular rec together with NeRF Studio. First download the app from the App Store and then we'll record a video using it. You should try to move the camera slowly to avoid motion blur. The camera brightness and color temperature settings are locked during the recording. And the focus distance is also locked, so try to stay at the same distance from the target to avoid image going out of focus. Keeping all the camera settings locked produces more stable reconstructions. Once the recording is done, the app allows you to upload the recorded videos to cloud storage of your choosing. If you have a lot of recordings, it might be faster to connect the phone to your PC directly via cable and transfer them in File Manager. Once the files are on your computer, you need to extract them. You can also inspect that the video looks good. Next, we'll install the SDK examples Git repository from GitHub. We'll use the replay to NeRF script to compute the camera trajectory and export the data into format that the NeRF Studio understands. The script has some dependencies, so install those in the Python virtual environment. You'll get a 3D preview of the camera trajectory while it's being computed. This will take some time to produce. The video you see here is sped up. Once the preliminary path is ready, it's further optimized. This might take a couple minutes. Now we have the data in the right format. The next step is to install the NeRF Studio if you don't have it yet. This can take a while and we'll skip it here to save time. Once NeRF Studio is set up, we'll use the NSTrain to start the training process. Use the directory given by the replay to NeRF Python script we used previously. You can open NeRF Studio in a browser to see the training in progress. Here you can see the finished NeRF reconstruction. You can easily set up a camera path and render out a video. That's all from me. Thank you for watching and please share your results using the pipeline shown here.